Lewis McManus hit 117 not out to lead the Hampshire resistance on day three against Surrey. Hampshire resumed on 73 for 2 and lost a wicket to the first ball of the day when Sibley trapped McLaren leg before for 31. Sibley had a second wicket in his next over, Allsop edging to Roy at first slip for 32. This meant that within the space of a few overs, leg spinner and batsman Sibley had trebled his first class wicket haul. Wheater and Irvine consolidated, putting on 102 for the fifth wicket. Wheater hit a maximum as he and Irvine continued to lead the Hampshire resistance. Wheater passed his 50 but couldn't convert it into a big score, picking out Davis at extra cover off the bowling of Footit, the batsman departing for 59. Irvine didn't last much longer, ran out by Burns for 52, Hampshire not helping themselves in fighting to save the draw. Berg decided the best form of defence was attack, hitting 40 from just 47 balls, including a maximum, dominating a stand of 52 with McManus. Berg was bowled by Batty to end the fun for the Hampshire 9, bringing Andrew to the wicket, and alongside McManus they shared a substantial partnership worth 71. McManus reached his 50 as the partnership continued to grow. Andrew had made a patient 19 but fell from the 55th delivery he faced, caught by Roy off Sam Curran. Not long afterwards, Crane was bowled by Batty for just one. McManus kept going, utterly dominating the scoring in a valuable 10th wicket partnership with Wheel. McManus reached his 100 and continued to narrow the first innings deficit. The last wicket stand was worth an unbroken 71 at close, McManus on 117 not out, Wheel on an important 7 not out from 67 balls at the other end. Hampshire 398 for 9 at stumps, still 239 runs behind with just one first innings wicket left, but with significant hope of still saving a draw on the final day.